We're going to talk about the game of Amazons. It was invented in Argentina by a chap named Walter Zemkowskaus, I believe, in the 1980s. So it's a fairly new game. For purposes of this video, I think we should use only a 6x6 board because this makes the game faster. This is a good game for kids at that size. The official size preferred by Zemkowskaus is 10x10, which is also the size of a checkerboard in Argentina. And you can also play an 8x8, or you play in any size, or could even be a rectangular board. Well, there's two black pieces and two white pieces, and there are various possible starting configurations. This is one that I like. A legal move is, let's just take one piece here. A legal move is by an Amazon. If you choose to move this Amazon, it can go as far as it wants in any direction, either diagonal or horizontal or vertical, like a chess queen. Now, after it moves, it must shoot an arrow. And the arrow also goes like a chess queen. The same Amazon that moved must also shoot. So maybe it shoots like that, okay. Now the square in which it lands, this is like a flaming arrow, it is burned off the board. And that square cannot be occupied, nor can any other Amazon jump over it or capture it. There's no capturing. All the Amazons are immortal. They run about shooting flaming arrows, and eventually the board gets blocked up with flaming arrows and somebody can't move. And when that happens, because they're unable to move, then the game's over and the player unable to move is the player who loses.
Or the player who did the last legal move is the winner.
That's right.
Okay.
Yes.
Sounds fun.
Okay, well it is. Brady's gonna play black and I'm gonna play white and we're gonna play a game. Well, let's say you can go first. It is believed there is an advantage to going first, but no one really knows.
I'm gonna go, so I'll go there. And then, so I could shoot my arrow, for example, to there?
Sure. That's okay.
All right.
I'll go here and shoot to there.
I'm gonna go to here and shoot my arrow to there.
Okay, so I'll go here and shoot there.
I'm feeling that black player getting a bit penned in there. So for example, I might move to here and then try and start penning in your white Amazon there.
Yep, that's highly plausible. So I'll go here and shoot there.
I'll go here and shoot to there.
Okay.
Was that a good or a bad move?
It's hard for me to tell. I think I'd better just go here and shoot here. There.
Okay. My black player's getting quite pinned in there, isn't he?
Yeah.
I feel like I need to get that guy out of trouble because I could get boxed in here quite easily, couldn't I?
True.
So I'm gonna come down to here and then fire my arrow here.
Well, that works to some extent.
Are you feeling good about your situation here?
Yeah, I feel pretty good. I'll go here and shoot here. So now the board is split into two games. There's one over here, in which I'm way ahead because I have a lot of space and you have only one. And there's another game over here. This divides the board into two pieces.
Is this common in games, for games to get split into sub-games like this?
Certainly in the kind of combinatorial games that we study, yes, because that's a big part of how we manage to do an analysis. Because in the mathematics, we can do an analysis of this side of the board. The result is not going to be too complicated because this is fairly simple. This over here is still fairly complicated, but we can do an analysis over here. We can do another analysis over here. And then we have ways of adding these two analyses together to get analysis of the whole game.
Is there a name for this technique?
Divide and conquer.
It feels like I'm pretty dead over this side now. Like
over here, there's a lot more at stake.
Yeah, right.
There's some squares back here you will probably get, and then there's some squares down here that
more likely I will get. And there's some in the middle that we'll be fighting over. So, okay. So presumably these two will be fighting for a while.
That's my move at the moment, isn't it?
Yes.
I'm going to go here and fire here.
Okay, so I think I will just go here and shoot here.
Oh, I made a mistake.
So now I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. You have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
Okay.
Unless I can move again, which I may come on here and argue with you.
Okay.
But at the moment, you have two moves more than I do here, probably, or roughly that. And over here, I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Six or seven moves ahead of you.
Go here and fire here.
Mm-hmm. So
this is sort of interesting. If I come in after you, you may cut me off. So I'm not sure what the best plan is here. I probably will do that anyway. I will come in and there.
Oh, I think you've got me beaten.
Yeah, I'm going to be okay here too.
If you can go back and and then I'll.
Well, then I'll just kill you out, and still get 3 points extra. See. But if you don't, I'll back up and get all these. And,
I'll go here and fire here.
So then I come here and shoot here.
Okay, so I only have one possible move, which is to go here and fire here.
Right.
Now
I start using up my moves. Shoot here.
And now I can't move. I can't move here. I can't move that. I can't move that.
And I still have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9.
Even if you had no more moves, you've won the game, though.
That's right. That's right.
Some sense we say I've won by 9 points. There's only one game against a beginner I've ever lost out of somewhere like 40 now.
You should have told me that before. I would have tried harder if I knew the stakes were so high.
Jujo Jang, who is a famous Nine Dan Go player, beat me the first game of Amazons we played.
Okay.
Although I challenged him to a rematch and I won the second. There are a number of levels at which it helps teach mathematics. For very small children and beginners, just observing that we have addition here. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 moves for white here and two moves here, so he wins by 9 points. Let's assume this ended some different way, something like that, for instance. Suppose the game had ended like this. See?
Oh, I would have preferred that.
Well, black has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 moves. White has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 moves. But white has another one, so white is ahead by 1 point. And white is one move ahead, so he will win, even if he has to go first. Now, after this, for instance, it's now 7 versus 7, and the mover will lose because this adds up to 0. So in general, we say a game is worth 0 when the mover cannot win. So a 0 game is one which is a win for the second player. The original game, as prescribed by Zassenhaus, is on a 10 by 10 board, and each side starts with 4 Amazons. On an 8 by 8, we usually have 3 against 3. And on a 6 by 6, it's usually 2 against 2. When we have an experienced player playing against a beginner, as I just did against Brady, it'd be a more interesting game if I gave him 3 Amazons against my 2.
So that's sometimes people play that way, they handicap.
Sure. That's one way to handicap. The other is just find a starting position in which one side's already more constrained than the other. And so you can start from positions that are biased in one direction or another. Well, yeah, I think it's an interesting game. I think the openings are, I don't understand them. I don't think anybody does. It's a game that is played. There have been international tournaments. Back in the early days of Amazons, they were played by fax. And now I'm sure everything's computerized. There are people who do research in it, yes. There are, Martin Mueller at the University of Alberta has done a fair amount of work, as have some other people, and trying to evaluate sizes of various positions. And I think by now it's sort of known how to play on very small boards, maybe 4 by 4. I don't think 6 by 6 is really understood yet. The board has no direction. I mean, all directions are equally good. In that sense, it's more like Go than like chess or checkers, where there is a forward component built into the game. This game has no forward component. Zassenhaus' starting position has the four blacks on one side lined up against the four on the other, which I think is a little distracting to beginners, because it sort of conveys this notion of forward motion coming at each other. But after a few moves, each side gets around behind the other usually, and it's up for grabs. There is no, the board really has no direction. We have a region here that's worth zero because there's no Amazon. But it turns out each of these positions is worth a half a point for a black. Run a chain through here, and the only way you're gonna be able to stop it is to sacrifice a box. Don't give away any sacrifices until you have to. Stop the side chains right away.